section to database microbachelor's program is a very applied program. And that's important to me. There's so much learning out on the internet today, which is terrific, but a lot of it is memorization. Here's some terms, here's what they mean, regurgitate them to. I wanted to make sure the database program was really about doing. So there are 52 labs that are hands-on experience for the students across the 3 1 credit courses. So the first course is what is called an introduction to queries, or introduction to database queries. And in this course, they learn the syntax to interact with the database, to ask it questions, to insert new facts into the database, to modify facts, and to delete facts. And it's really a slow, steady introduction to databases. And the students do labs where they interact with a commercial database system. We use MySQL in the labs, mainly because any student can download it. It runs on almost any platform, so you can run it on Windows, Mac, Linux. So students can download a copy, play with it, and then they can submit in the labs their results to these problems. So in the first course, it's really about learning the syntax of this language. In the next course, it's really about finding ways to express more complicated queries, things like aggregates or using queries inside queries, that sort of thing. And that's a lot of what drives business today, sort of KPIs or dashboards of information. And that's what you're getting in that second part of the database course, is how do we express these? The third course is called Advanced Administration. And really in that course, we're building objects in the server that can help us do more work. These can be things like stored programming in the server, or views that allow users to see some of the information, but not all the information. So for example, maybe we've got a payroll table, and I want you to see the directory of employees in the company, but not their salary. So that's the kind of things we learned in that third course, is how we build objects that others can use either in applications or interacting with the database from those first couple courses. But I think the best part is when you walk away with this course, you've written 52 successful queries that solve problems, real problems that people have. Now I said we use MySQL, but this applies to lots of other databases. So at the very end of that last course, I have a lecture that says, other things you need to learn. And it's the things we couldn't get to in a 3 credits program, but they're things that I want you to keep going. So I give you links for reading. So we talk about other commercial databases like Microsoft SQL and Oracle and IBM DB2 and MariaDB and NoSQL databases. So students really walk away with concrete skills they can use, but also knowing where they need to go next. Students with these core skills across these 2 micro bachelors, programming in a procedural language like Python, networking, operating systems, and a strong experience in databases, relational databases. These are really the foundation of almost any of these technical disciplines. So it's really a critical part that going in cybersecurity, it's a critical part going in information technology, because these are the systems we maintain. And it's a critical knowledge base if you're going into computer science, because now you're going to build on top of this with things like artificial intelligence, machine learning, more software engineering or core programming, those sorts of topics.